I dare not try. Hallelujah, Christ is risen indeed. Welcome to worship at Jubilee on this Easter Sunday. How wonderful that we're able to be together today. Thank God. Welcome to those of you who are watching on Zoom today, and to those of you who will be worshiping along with us later in the week. Welcome to everyone. To begin our Easter service, we're going to enjoy again the 2020 Christ is Risen Jubilee Easter video.
Happy Easter Jubilee.
Christ has risen.
Christ has risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee. The Lord is risen. The Lord is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee. The Lord is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee, Christ is risen, Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee, Christ is risen, Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter, Christ is risen, Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee, Christ is risen, Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter everybody, we love y'all, happy Easter.
Happy Easter Jubilee. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed.
The Lord is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Happy Easter Jubilee.
Happy Easter Jubilee.
The Lord is risen. He's risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed.
Say hey, Cuckoo.
Happy Easter Jubilee. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee. He is risen. He is risen.
Happy Easter Jubilee. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee. God bless you. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Amen.
Happy Easter. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter Jubilee. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter Jubilee. Our opening song this morning is What a Beautiful Name. Worship along with this lovely call to worship.
What a beautiful name.
wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. He didn't want heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater.
Please pray with me. We gather this morning, Lord Jesus Christ, to honor your beautiful name and to thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for dying. Thank you for rising again. Thank you for the forgiveness and hope that comes through the salvation you struggled to provide. Thank you for generously offering your peace to the whole world. Thank you for demonstrating your humility and your power. We gather today in your honor to name you risen King and to celebrate your supremacy and your victory. We name you, we claim you, risen Lord, creator and redeemer of all. Flood our conversation, our congregation, flood our hearts and our world with your joyful presence. Come, Lord Jesus, in your triumph and your brilliance. Create among us and in this world the heavenly kingdom you proclaim. May our lives be the sign of your extravagant love, so in some small way to honor you. Amen. You'll find in your benches a bulletin, and you're welcome to follow along with that and to take it home with you. Or if you're worshiping on Zoom, you'll see the screen of the order of worship provided now. If you have prayer requests, you're welcome to text them to Pastor Duane for the prayer time that's coming, or in a few moments, you can also just raise your hand and he'll bring the mic your way. I'll pray a blessing over our offering. If you'd like to leave an offering, there's a jar at the back of the sanctuary provided for you. The worship song, He Arose, will follow that, and then the prayer time. Amy Yoder has videotaped herself telling a story for the children, and then Sharon Dufour will read our text, John 21 to 18. Pastor Duane will preach our message for today, and then we're looking forward to Kelsey and Theresa singing Extravagant. Please pray with me again as we bless and lift up our offering. We thank you, O God, for the gifts you've given us, and we ask you to receive our humble attempts at thank you through the offerings we share with this congregation and so with you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Welcome to our prayer time. If you have a praise or a prayer request that you'd like to share, please stand and move to the end of your bench, either end, and Pastor Dwayne will bring the mic. You don't have to hold it. He'll hold it for you. Just stand and he'll be glad to help you share your prayer request. We're continuing to pray for Carlos and his family, so please continue to remember them. Is there anyone who has something they'd like to share? Ah, yes, Charlotte.
Have a big praise. I've been having trouble with my eyes, and there's macular degeneration in my family. So I finally went to the eye doctor, and I do not have macular degeneration. I do not have it.
That's a huge relief, isn't it? Praise God. Thanks for sharing that. Someone else. Anything you'd like to share? Let's pray together. Oh God, we give you thanks that always you are working in our lives and in this world, when we see it, when we don't. We ask for mercy. For all the frayed and broken places, we ask your tending and your mending. For all the gifts we have forgotten to count, we give you thanks. We give you thanks with Charlotte this morning that she got good news about her eyes, that she does not have macular degeneration. We give you thanks, oh God. And we ask you to keep watch over Carlos and his family. Have mercy on them, deliver them from every difficulty. And we thank you that you are watching over them, even though they are so far from us. We pray for grace to live in your resurrection hope in this week ahead. Through Christ we pray, and with the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If there's something else that you'd like to share with Jubilee, please text that to Dwayne or I, or email that, and we'll include what you have to share in Jubilee's newsletter tomorrow. Well, now, kids, get ready for the Jesus Loves Me song, and then a story from Amy.
Good morning, everyone. This morning, I decided it would be great to have some scrambled eggs for breakfast. So I think that's what I'm going to do. Do you enjoy eating eggs? Maybe scrambled eggs or an egg in a nest? They're just all so good. Well, even if you don't like eggs, that's okay, because you probably still know what an egg looks like, so you'll still be able to help me with today's lesson. So, when I have scrambled eggs, I normally have two eggs. And how do you make eggs? How do you get them out of here? We normally have to crack the eggs, right? We have to crack the eggs into the bowl, scramble them, and cook them on the stove. Well, when I crack these eggs, what do you expect to see inside? If you said an egg yolk and egg whites, that's right. We do expect to see those when we crack the eggs open, right? Well, I need you to watch very closely and see if that's what you see inside these eggs when I crack them. So first, let's crack this one. And what came out? There's an egg yolk and some egg whites. Now let's crack the second one. What's inside? Did you say it's empty? There's nothing inside? How can that be possible? Well, you might need to ask me about that another time. But you know something? This empty egg reminds me of the Easter story. And let me explain a little bit why. You see, when Jesus died, his body was put in a tomb, which is kind of like, maybe you can think of it like a cave. And when that happened, this was a very sad time for everyone who loved Jesus. And there were some women who loved Jesus very much, and they decided to go early morning. In the early morning, they went to his tomb. And what do you think they expected to see when they got to the tomb? They expected to see Jesus' body, right? Just like you expected to see an egg yolk and egg whites in this egg when we cracked it open. Well, do you know what happened? When they got to that tomb, the tomb was empty. And this was a much bigger surprise than finding an empty egg, right? The women were shocked and they were so surprised. But when they learned that the reason that this tomb was empty was because Jesus was alive, they were filled with so much joy. And today, on Easter Sunday, we get to celebrate that Jesus is alive. So I want you to think, anytime that you see an egg, I want you to remember the egg that I cracked open that was empty. And let it remind you of the women finding the tomb empty and the joy that they had when they learned that Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive.
Amen. Thank you for that lesson. Sharon Dufour is going to come and read John 21 to 18 for us, and then Pastor Dwayne will share a message, He is Risen.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciples, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciples started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter. Lost my place, sorry. But the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came along behind him and went straight into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was still lying in its place, separate from the linen. Finally, the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to where they were staying. Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned toward him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news. "I have seen the Lord," she said. She told them that he had said these things to her.
I enjoyed studying this passage again. I enjoyed putting myself into the story and trying to feel some of what the feelings were that day. Let's see if we can feel some of what Mary Magdalene was feeling that morning. Alone, here early in the morning, in Luke 2, we see where Jesus freed Mary Magdalene from seven demons. And Jesus helped her find life worth living. She had great love and great respect for Jesus. Jesus was one of her best friends. She was missing Jesus. She was right there near Jesus at the cross. Likely, Mary could not sleep the last several days for what all happened this past week. Likely, it was probably early morning, say around 3 o'clock, and Mary's not able to sleep, and she heads to the tomb. It's dark, probably damp. Her heart was hurting. Damp and dark with tears. Alone. Feeling like everybody else is able to sleep, but I can't. When Mary got to the tomb, the stone that was protecting the grave was rolled away. This big stone, like a cartwheel, was moved to the side and left it open. This big stone, maybe 6 feet tall, very heavy, was moved sideways, and it was open. In Matthew 27, verse 66, he tells us that the stone actually had a seal that the authorities put on it just to make sure nobody messed with it. Just to make sure that the disciples were not going to steal the body. Well, maybe the Jews took the body away.
what could have happened? And here we have Mary near that grave out there, almost dark. It overwhelmed Mary. She needed her backup quick. Nobody would have believed her if she didn't have backup anyhow. And really, she shouldn't be there alone in the dark, next to a grave like that. Well, in fact, we're the robbers even around the corner right now. All the things that could have went through Mary's mind at that moment. That is when Mary went running and she found her backup. Peter and probably John came back with her. All three of them, they did a bunch more running. It sounds like Peter and Mary, they got beat coming back to the tomb. But nobody had the nerve to go inside the tomb until Peter came, and he just went bolting on in. The clothes that wrapped Jesus were still there. Doing a little detective work, it appeared that Jesus had not been stolen. Like the scripture says, he saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the burial cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was folded up by itself, separate from the linen. As I thought about this, wow. There the cloth is, sort of like Jesus' body is supposed to be right there, but gone. I like this next verse. Finally, the other disciple, probably John, who reached the tomb first, he also went in. And when he saw, he believed. When he saw the clothes and all, he believed. It doesn't say Mary and Peter believed. The disciples went back to their homes. Mary stayed outside the tomb. She was crying. She lost one of her best friends. This friend that saved her from the demons. She owed so much to Jesus. While she was crying there, she saw two angels in the tomb, back where Jesus' body had been. The angels asked Mary, "Why are you crying?" What kind of a question is that? They knew what was going on. Mary answered, "They have taken my Lord away and I don't know where they put him." At that point, Jesus was standing there. And Mary didn't realize it was Jesus. Plus, Mary's eyes probably were full of tears, and maybe she wasn't seeing the most clear. Plus, that was the last person she was expecting to see at that moment, in spite of all that she heard the last several weeks. Then Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?" Right. Like Jesus didn't know who Mary would have been looking for. Then Mary said, thinking maybe this fellow was the gardener, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where they put him." This next words are my favorite words of this whole passage. When Jesus just says, "Mary." What happened to Mary's heart when she heard that at that moment? All she could say was, "Teacher." At that point, she was a believer of the resurrection. She had no questions after that point. And that's when Jesus said, "Do not touch me," because he had to go back. She was probably getting ready to give him one of these big southern bear hugs, but she had to wait. In this last verse, I reckon how fast Mary went when she left. I think Mary had it in high speed when she went back. I think this last trip, she may have even went faster than the first couple trips. Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them what all was happening. Jesus definitely gave Mary a message to share, a message that she could not wait to share. Jesus is risen. He is not in the grave. Mary's message is the heart of Christianity. A Christian is a person that can say, "I have seen the Lord." Christianity does not mean knowing about Jesus. It means knowing him. It does not mean arguing about him. It means meeting him. It means the certainty of experiencing that Jesus is alive. And all of us today can experience that Jesus is alive. Amen.
Shoulders, and you stopped at nothing. See you.
In memory of the extravagant love of Jesus, we're going to share in the Lord's Supper together. Even on this day, when we remember Jesus' resurrection, we remember his death for us. In this service this morning, Kelsey, Joel, Duane, and I will come to you, each of us, with a tray. You will serve yourself from the trays that will come to either end of your bench. We have slightly malfunctioning cups that have a wafer on the top and the grape juice in the bottom. If you have trouble getting them opened, it's not you. We've also provided crackers for those anticipating their baptisms. If you find that you prefer the crackers, you're welcome to take those as well. And after everyone has received, we will eat and drink together. So just hold your cup. Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had broken it, he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this as often as you eat it in remembrance of me." And in the same way, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, "This is the blood of the new covenant given for you. Bless, O God, this cup we share. Make it a true communion with you and with your church. Amen." Jubilee, the body of Christ broken for you. We thank you, precious Jesus, for your sacrifice for us. We pray that you will remember us as we remember you. Amen. We invite you, Jubilee, to share your responses to today's service or how God has moved in your heart. Pastor Dwayne will pass the mic again. If you have something you want to share, just please stand and he'll bring the mic your way. I want to thank Theresa especially for coordinating the song service in the parking lot. Thank you, Theresa. If you have anything you want to share, just feel free to text us and we'll be happy to include it in the newsletter. You'll find some announcements in your bulletin and also in on the slide there. Fern, you have something to share?
If any women are planning to attend women's retreat and you haven't talked with me or Rhoda, if you could do that today, please.
Okay, thank you, Fern. Joel has an announcement.
I have several announcements, so hang with me here. I'll try to be concise. The first one is this coming Sunday morning during Jubilee Campout, there will be a youth breakfast fundraiser. All proceeds will go towards the youth group's fundraising effort to attend the Mennonite Youth Convention this summer. So again, that's next Sunday morning, 8:30 to 9:30 at Pine Lake Camp, breakfast fundraiser. Bring your appetites, all donations are welcome. The second announcement, in the newsletter this past week, I mentioned that we have a junior youth event scheduled for April 11th. That's actually being moved to April 18th. So the next junior youth event will be April 18th. More details to follow on that in the next few days. The third announcement, final announcement, thanks for your patience. Financial assistance is available through Jubilee for anyone interested in attending Pine Lake Summer Camp this summer. So if you know of someone in the ages, I believe it's the age range is age 6 to 17 who's interested in attending Pine Lake Summer Camp, if you know someone who needs financial assistance, let me know. We have a scholarship fund that we can help with that. And if you're interested in making a donation towards Jubilee Scholarship Fund, also let me know and I can make sure the funds get to the right spot. Thanks.
Thank you to our hardworking Minister of Youth and Young Adults who also doubles as our AV man wearing many hats. Thank you, Joel. You all have heard about the quilting workshop and retreat that's coming up at Pine Lake Camp. And the big news is that Jubilee is having a camp out this year. Yay. And it's next Sunday. There won't be services here in this building and there won't be Zoom services, but we will have in-person services at Pine Lake at 10:45 in front of the lodge. So there won't be services here, but they'll be out at camp. We're going to have meals out of camp, and you know what would really help us? Lisa's making sure there's sandwiches on Saturday noon. Dwayne and I are gonna order some pizza for Saturday night, and Bonnie's ordering a chicken dinner for Sunday, and it would really help to know how many of y'all wanna come because We would just really hate not to have enough pizza or chicken for you. So please let Kelsey know. You can register online in the newsletter tomorrow, or you can just call Kelsey or text her and let her know. And we'll extrapolate pizza count from that. You've heard also that there's going to be a baptism. Janelle and Brianna Grable are going to be baptized on Sunday afternoon. They're very excited about this and have anticipated this for a long time. And we hope that you'll join us at 2 at the swimming area on Sunday for this important event. There is a brochure on the back table near the offering jar that describes all the events that are coming up, to the best of our knowledge, at Pine Lake next weekend. So please pick one up on your way out. You've heard about women's retreat and senior retreat, also a gathering for Gulf States that's coming. Check your newsletter tomorrow for more details about Jubilee's coming events, or just let us know. We'll be happy to put your announcement in the newsletter. Good news, we're just continuing our attempts at recollecting ourselves, Jubilee. And this morning, Katya, would you raise your hand, please? Calling her out. Thank you, dear. Katya is going to take your picture because we're going to put up a Jubilee bulletin board again with everybody's photographs. So we hope that you'll stick around and let Katya take your picture today for the bulletin board. Also, it's been our tradition to share the Easter lilies on Easter Sunday afternoon with those who are shut in or those who can't attend service for some reason. So if there is someone that we have prayed for here at Jubilee that you are close to, or someone that you know that would benefit from a lily today, I hope that you'll pick one up and take it with you after the service. So when it's your turn to be dismissed, when your bench is dismissed, instead of walking out the back, just come up the front and take a lily and go on out this way through the foyer. Just take one with you to share on Easter Sunday afternoon as a gift from Jubilee. That was a lot of announcements. Please check your bulletins. Did I miss something, Dwayne, that you can think of right off? Okay, great. Well, again, what a wonderful joy to be able to celebrate Easter together this year. And we look forward to lots more times to worship and serve together in the future. Jubilee, please hear our benediction. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Amen.